Hey friends, Azure Advisor is like having your own cloud expert, keeping an eye on all of your resources. It's constantly looking for issues with security, reliability, cost, performance, and operational excellence. These are all pillars of the Azure well-architected framework. Jose Portugal is here to show the latest about this service that keeps getting smarter today on Azure Friday. Hey friends, I'm Scott Hanselman and it's Azure Friday. I'm here with Jose Portugal and we're talking about Azure Advisor. I've actually noticed the Azure Advisor. It's in my portal and it gives me all kinds of information about what's going on, recommendations and security, and it just gets better and better. It has different features each month.
That is correct, like Scott. We do keep working on like adding like recommendations like constantly. We're always like getting feedback from our customers. We're always looking for like other ways to delight them. So yeah, like if you keep an eye on Azure Advisor, you will see that like our catalog keeps growing and the ways that we try to help our customers like as well.
And the catalog is like in the hundreds now. It's many hundreds, like 500 plus recommendations.
Yes, we have more than 500 recommendations. We work with more like than 100 like groups within like Azure that give us telemetry. We look into basically like, the usage you have of your resources. We keep always an eye and we're always looking into adding like additional recommendations to that set.
And are these aren't like, you're not trying to upsell me. These aren't recommendations like you should spend more money. These are recommendations to help you, to make the product more secure, to make the product run more smoothly.
Correct. Yeah. Like most of our recommendations are like security, performance, like et cetera. But we do even have like the cost savings category. We're not trying to like actually upsell you. We're trying to save our customers money, right? Obviously, like some of our recommendations might like be adding or like increasing capacity, et cetera, which like obviously comes with a cost. But obviously, like that's always up to the customer. We always base it on the usage. We give them recommendations. But we are always trying to, like you know, like improve like the resource status and also to save the money in the process if we can.
Yeah, I really liked that. The last time I looked at Azure Advisor, there's actually a cost section that was recommending that I lower some virtual machines that were not working very hard to a different.
Correct.
You know, to save me money. So like things that you've forgotten or resources that you may have forgotten. So yeah, it definitely helps a lot. Maybe you can show us what this looks like.
Okay, let me go ahead and share my screen. The first thing is I'm going to show you like how to get to like Azure Advisor, just in case like for people who don't know like how to find it. So you can find like Azure Advisor by coming to our portal, and then like in the menu you can find like under like Advisor, or you can also always come directly and type just like Advisor on like the resource bar, and you will find it over here. So this is like the Azure Advisor portal. So as you can see, like there are like here, like plenty of like the recommendations we talked about. Like we have like the five categories, which are like the pillars of the well-architect framework. So you will find recommendations that are like in the cost savings category, on the security category, also reliability, operational excellence, and performance. So as you can see, like it will tell you, for example, for cost savings, like you can have like at a glimpse, like how much like savings that you can get by following these recommendations. You will see about like how many recommendations per category you have, like how many impacted resources, and also like the priority or like the importance of those like recommendations that we have for you. And now let me show you what it looks like when you go into like a specific category to see like your recommendations. For example, in this case, like I have selected like more than half of my subscriptions. You can come here and change like the subscriptions to which you want to like see your recommendations. I have two recommendations for this set of subscriptions. We have like 10 impacted resources, like almost like 4K, like a potential yearly savings, right? So like the recommendation like list like you can find over here with impact is description, potential yearly savings for like the category like cost savings and the impacted resources. You can also like come in there and then like you will see like the details about your recommendation, right? So in this case, for example, it's suggesting to me that I resize my SQL databases to save some resources based on the usage that I'm having of those like databases, right? So another thing that you can see is like it will tell you like which subscription this like belongs to, like what like the additional details for they are. And you can like take different actions, right? So like you can go and see like the resource directly to see what it's about. You can see what the recommended actions by the recommendation is. Like in this case, for example, if I click on it, it will bring me directly to the place where I can take action on that specific recommendation. So Another thing that you can do as well is like, in a case that at this moment, for example, you don't really care about this recommendation or you think like it's okay, you can always postpone it and this recommendation will come back to you later. Or you can just like flat out dismiss it. This is like, for example, a resource you don't like care much about. It's like one of your like test resources, or it's just something you are trying out. You can come up and then like dismiss like the recommendation, and then we will stop showing that to you. So that is like basically like the gist of like how like recommendations work. I can show you as well, for example, like for other categories, right? Like security, it's an important one. Like in security, like we work very closely with like Azure Security Center. So the recommendations that you see here will match also what you will see on Security Center. Okay, now I will show you a little bit about like a couple of like other features that you can use to keep up to date with like the recommendations that Advisor has calculated for you. So a few of the things that we have is you can like download like a full PDF or like all the recommendations we have for you. Like if you need to keep reports or if you want to like share it with somebody in like a more like a friendly way, you can download like a list as part of like as a PDF or like a CSV as well. Couple other features that like we have been like adding is like for example the ability for you to have like alerts, right? You can come like to Advisor Alerts. You can create your own alerts in which you come and tell us basically which subscriptions, the resource groups that you want the alerts to be working for, and you can make like a few configurations about like category, the impact level, the recommendation type. You select your action group, and then you can create like the name and create the alert. And then anytime that a specific like recommendation that matches like what you have selected comes up, you will get like alerted about it. One more thing that like I want to show you as well is like how you can like work with recommendation digests. Sometimes like you have like multiple subscriptions, like multiple resources, like it's not like very easy for people to keep an eye on like all the resources at one time. So another thing you can do is you can come and create like new recommendation digests. On the same vein that like the alerts, you can come, you tell us like a few parameters, like how often like do you want like these digests to like come to you, either weekly, biweekly, monthly. You can tell us about like which categories you care about, and you can select one of like the multiple languages that Azure supports. And after you fill like those details, you will start getting in that frequency basically a ready digest for you to look into what the status is for like your recommendations.
So are you saying that it'll send me the digest and like a report, like, hey, you haven't been to Azure Advisor in a while. Take a look. There's new stuff for you. So it's almost like a newsletter of advice.
That is correct. Like you can create your own newsletter. It will be like at your own frequency. We don't like spamming people. Uh-huh. We don't like spam. So you come here, you configure it, you like make it like fit your parameters, the things that you care the most about. And that is like what we will be sending you on the frequency that you have. And you can always come back like in here for a specific like digest you have. You can enable it, disable it, modify the frequency. Whatever works best for you is like what you should get. Okay, so now like let me go into our like latest feature that like I want to like show to you guys. So this is like Advisor Score. So one of like the common feedback that we get is like for like many of our customers, right? You have like multiple subscriptions, like dozens of them. You can have hundreds of resources. It's like sometimes it's complicated, right? To keep a track of like all those recommendations, which ones matter the most. Well, what is the actual status, right, of my like Azure like resources? And how am I doing? That's a question we get very often. How am I doing? So like this that I'm presenting to you guys, like it's Advisor Score, basically takes all the recommendations for like the subscription you have selected and then calculates a simple number like 0 to 100 that gives you like a pretty good idea of how are you doing in each one of the categories that we have. Each one of the five pillars will have its own like score around here. You can say, for example, oh, I'm doing great on operational excellence, doing great on performance. I should probably take a look at my security like recommendations. There's like some room for improvement here. And also, like, probably I should take a look at my cost savings, like, see there's some savings for me, like potential savings. And also, it provides you with a trend line, right, of how are you doing and how have you been improving over time, right? Any changes? And you can see over here, like, what has been your score, like, for the past couple of months. And you can also, like, come over here and select and change what basically is the granularity of, like, the trend line that you want to look at. So, again, like, with this, like, it's the same subset of recommendations. This is just, like, a new experience that we are, like, providing to our customers to, like, give them, like, at a single place where they can come and at a glimpse look at and say, hey, these are, like, the categories that I am, like, you know, I'm most interested in. These are, like, the ones, like, advice or things I should, like, probably, like, take, like, a deeper look at. And you can come, again, and just look at your recommendations directly by clicking on the categories. You will see them over here. And then just as you have them here, you will see also an additional column that will tell you for a specific recommendation, what is the specific impact or, like, what is, like, the score impact that you will, like, see if you resolve that recommendation. So that's, like, one of, like, the things that has been, like, working very well lately. Now, it's very easy for us to see, okay, let's sort our recommendations by the ones that have, like, the biggest, like, impact in my score. So all of this, like, impact is obviously calculated on the advisor side. We work with many teams to do weights on the recommendations, to analyze the usage, and to come up with, like, what is the best, like, way for us to improve those scores, right? So biggest improvement on the score means, like, a bigger weight on the recommendation, means that we think you should look into those recommendations first.
This is almost like your credit score, except they're telling you exactly how your credit score will be affected by your behavior, which they don't tell you. So it's not an opaque score. It's very transparent.
Correct. It is very transparent. Like, we tell you exactly where you are right now, basically, like, how will you improve with every specific action that you take. And it is, like, obviously, it reflects directly. Or if you take a look at the gap or, like, the impact that you have, like, missing to get to 100, you can come to your recommendations and you can see that, like, once you start, like, adding the numbers, they will add, like, and bring you up to 100. So that is, like, the experience. Like, Azure Advisor is, like, Advisor Score is already available for people, like, in their own, like, advisor portal. So please feel free to take a look. We always, by the way, like, love hearing back from our customers. You will see that we have, like, our feedback buttons enabled. We keep, like, a pretty close eye on those, like, on that feedback. We are always trying to be active on those things and take care of the issues that, like, our, like, customers report and things they care about to keep improving Advisor and Advisor Score, like, adding more features, more functionality, anything we can do to try to make their lives easier.
That's actually a really good reminder for Azure in general. I appreciate that you brought that up because there's a real human being on the other side of those feedback forms, and you're one of those human beings. So when people want to learn more about Azure Advisor, when they want to share their opinions about the product, you and your team are on the other side making it better for them.
Oh, that is correct. Like, we read those, like, on a weekly basis. We go one by one. So this is not some kind of, like, automated machine that we'll just, like, take. We just go have, like, humans, the team actually, like, together. We go through our feedback, and we're always looking for, like, you know, like, some of our best ideas we have gotten from, like, customers that provide feedback. And, like, we look forward to keep getting that feedback for sure.
Fantastic. And now, do people have this now? Like, everyone, there may be people who are watching Azure Friday. They've been watching for years. They didn't know Azure Advisor exists. Do they have to sign up for anything, or they just go straight to it in the portal?
You can go straight to it on the portal. It's available for everybody. Like, this is, like, a free service. Like, you can, everybody with an Azure subscription can get access to Advisor. So by all means, it's already live, like, both, like, Advisor and, like, Advisor Score. So you can just go directly to your portal and start benefiting, start looking into how to, like, actually improve, like, all of your Azure resource management in here.
Fantastic. This is great. I am going to go and re-explore my scores. And I think I may actually set up that weekly email, because I would love to have a digest of things that I may have missed in the past.
Yeah, absolutely.
Fantastic. I am learning all about Azure Advisor, your one-stop place for Azure best practices, today on Azure Friday.
Hey, thanks for watching this episode of Azure Friday. Now I need you to like it, comment on it, tell your friends, retweet it. Watch more Azure Friday.